Many different candidates have been suggested as the real Shakespeare. A few of them are Mary Sidney, Amelia Bassano, and Henry Neville. Mary Sidney was born in October 1561 to Sir Henry Sidney and Lady Mary Dudley Sidney. When she was 15, the Queen invited her to court, where her uncle arranged her marriage to the Earl of Pembroke. They soon had four children, but two of them died in the mid-1580s. After the death of her two children, she stayed in the Pembroke country estate for 2 years. 1588, however, she returned to London and re-entered public life. Soon after, she began serving as patron to writers and also wrote two poems of her own, both praising her brother Philip. Although it was unacceptable for women to write plays for the stage, she wrote a closet drama, a play meant to be read at home and never performed. She continued to write other works, but her writing always reflected what was expected of female writers. It always fit into one of the three categories that were acceptable for women at the time, elegy, encomium, or translation, and she often returned to religious themes in her work. However, where most female writers at her time apologized for their writing, she never even mentioned her role as a female writer. She died of smallpox in 1621. Mary Sidney was fluent in French, Latin, Hebrew, and Italian, and she is thought to have known Welsh, Spanish, and Greek as well. She also played several musical instruments and participated in theatrical productions. In Shakespeare's works, there are 2,000 references to music and many words and phrases in Italian. Shakespeare from Stratford had very little education, and we have no reason to believe that he played musical instruments or spoke Italian, making it very unlikely that he would have had the skills necessary to write the plays. Mary Sidney was alive for the entire time that Shakespeare was writing, and is a documented writer with all of the skills necessary to write Shakespeare's plays, as well as the motivation to write under a pseudonym. Another author who has been suggested is Amelia Bassano. She was born to a family of probably Jewish Venetian immigrants. When she was 7, she was taken in by Susan Bertie, the Dowager Countess of Kent. Her early life reflects the life of the heroine of All's Well That Ends Well, who was also educated by a Dowager Countess from a young age. Susan Bertie's brother worked as an ambassador in Denmark, where Hamlet was set. When she was a teenager, Amelia Bassano became the mistress of Henry Carey, the patron of Shakespeare's acting company. She later spent time in court, giving her the experience to write plays about characters in court, and also spoke fluent Italian, which she had learned from her Venetian family, and had many relatives who worked as professional musicians. Additionally, disguised in the nonsense words in All's Well That Ends Well is Hebrew, a language that Shakespeare from Stratford would not have spoken, but Amelia Bassano and her Jewish family would have. The name Amelia is also the most common name in Shakespeare's works, and Bassano appears as a name in The Merchant of Venice. The final candidate is Henry Neville. He was born around 1562 to a wealthy family. He studied Latin, Greek, and astronomy and mathematics at Oxford University and later visited France, Germany, Poland, and Italy. His travels and studies would have given him knowledge of the language required to write Shakespeare's plays. He also played the lute and grew up in a musical family. Neville worked as a member of Parliament for many years and even briefly as an ambassador, which would have given him some knowledge of politics, which would have been useful in writing Shakespeare's play. In 1601, he was imprisoned in the Tower of London for participating in a rebellion. His imprisonment would explain the change in Shakespeare's writing around this time. Before then, Shakespeare's plays consisted mostly of comedies, but around 1601 they shifted to tragedies, such as Hamlet. After his release from the Tower in 1603, Neville worked more in government until he died in 1615. Although Neville's story would fit with the timeline of Shakespeare's writing, the only evidence pointing to Neville as a candidate is circumstantial, and there is no proof that Neville was a writer at all. There is also no obvious reason for him to write with a pseudonym. There is some evidence pointing to Mary Sidney, Amelia Bassano, or Henry Neville as the real Shakespeare, but none of the arguments presented are conclusive and there is no absolute proof of their authorship.